Welcome, 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 welcome to my channel, Sugar and Spice. This is Chyna, and today's video is, this is Chyna, I mean, there's nobody here. I'm Chyna. Welcome, 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 welcome to my channel, Sugar and Spice, Chyna here. So today's video is about that staple of the American summer wardrobe that pretty much launches 1,000 outfits in the summer, one which I personally can't do without, I don't know about you, and that is the denim short. The denim shorts. So I have about 6 or 7 shorts that I'm gonna show you. Those 6 or 7 shorts are represented by 4 brands, and each of these 4 brands are at 4 different price points. So they range high-end, in my opinion, high-end, all the way to a pair of shorts that are under $20. In my experience, every single brand that you can name probably has a denim short associated with it. It can get overwhelming. However, years of experience, trying them out, wearing them, etc., I've narrowed it down to probably, in all honesty, 2 brands that I absolutely love. But for the purposes of this video, I wanted to show you more than just 2 brands, so I expanded it out to 4. At 4 different price points. One thing that I've noticed is that they're all distressed shorts. You know, after looking at them, putting them side by side, I noticed they're all distressed. None of them are cuffed, none of them are pleated, none of them are paper bag, etc. But they are all distressed, and they're different washes. And the other thing that I want to do in this video is answer that question, that pseudo beef that's going on, which is better, Levi's or a Goldie jeans? And I don't even know if it's a thing. I just know that I've seen it out there, people comparing and contrasting the two. I think both of them are actually hold their own in different categories. So we'll go through that and see if we can't come up with a winner. I don't know if we will. It might be pseudo beef that I'm creating, but who cares? It's fun. So without further ado, let's get into it. Most importantly, before we get into it, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Please give me a thumbs up once you're done with the video, or even now, I don't care. I mean, give me a thumbs up now. Hopefully you'll like the video. And please press the bell that gives you the notification bell that lets you know when I've uploaded a new video. It'll send you an email, and I tend to upload on a weekly basis. So keep coming back and keep giving me love. And with that, let's get into the video. So the first couple that I'm going to show you are by a brand called A Goldie, and they are the most expensive out of all the shorts that I'm going to show you, coming in at a whopping $128. And as far as I can tell, they do not go on sale. So are they worth it? I mean, that truly is the question. And in fact, when you compare them to the Levi's, which I will do, and knowing that Levi's go on sale, I believe that if you are using that as a category, Levi's will win out. However, I'm getting ahead of myself, A Goldie. So, A G-O-L-D-E, this is a size 25. This particular style is called a Parker. It is not high-waisted. They have, I believe, 9 different styles that you can choose from. Don't quote me on this, but the Jaden or the Jordan or whatever are the high-waisted ones. These aren't. I am not a very tall person. I'm 5'3" as a point of reference. My inseam, which is measured from like your crotch to the top of your ankle, is 29 inches. So I am all leg, and I am very short-waisted. When I wear anything high-waisted, it just looks comical because my legs are super long, which can be good in you know, certain occasions. In fact, in all occasions, you just need to know how you can dress your body. And so for me, high-waisted, it does not suit me, especially when it comes to denim shorts. So I bought the Parker, which is not that high-waisted, and I love it. The next one, and I'll go more into more detail on both of these, this is also A Goldie, and this is also a Parker, just a darker wash. I believe this one is called Low Key, the wash, and this one is called Swap Meet, if I'm not mistaken. The distress on Low Key is not that much. Both have a raw hem. Both have buttonfly. The distress on this one, on Swap Meet, is a little bit more pronounced than it is in Low Key. Both are sized 25, And what else can I tell you? Inseam is 2.5 inches. So it's not super short. When you see the try-on portion of it, it's not like my butt's hanging out. And they fit really, really well. They're 100% cotton. That is one of the nice things. And with age, as with anything that is 100% cotton, especially when it comes to denim, you probably have this experience with some favorite jeans that you've worn for ages. It just molds to your body beautifully. And that's what's gonna happen to these. As they age, they will begin to mold to my body. And that is like the best feeling. Can you hear the dogs? The quality on these is superb. And they are, I mean, do you need two pairs? No. Do you wanna have a pair that you can invest in? Are they worth the money? I think so. I mean, I don't regret buying these two. And I know I'm gonna have them for years to come. I mean, it's one of those where it's just gonna sit in my closet, and the style isn't one that is going to go out of style. I mean, I know that I said that a little weird. You know what I mean. It's not gonna go out of style. I mean, you can always look back. There's distressed denim has always been around. So it's not like it's, you know, I don't know. Super, I can't even think of a trend in denim shorts that, you know, maybe Bermuda, the 90s boyfriend that's in right now. This is not that. So I think it is pretty timeless and pretty classic, and it can last a while. Next, we go into Levi's 501 jeans. Okay, so this is a darker wash. And again, it is similar to the first A Goldie that I showed you, also the darker wash. It does not have that much distressing on it. This is also 100% cotton. This is also button fly. The waist on these, however, is a 26. So I ordered a 25 because that's what I usually wear in jeans, and that's what I usually wear in the other denim that I have, is a size 25. When I got the 25 in the 501, they were way, way too tight. That took me by surprise because I don't know why the size would change, but it did. And I had to buy these in a 26. So these are a size 26 and 100% cotton. And this is the Levi's premium brand. Now, I looked it up, and from what I understand, the premium brand means it's got more stitching per inch. And it also has this leather patch. I'm trying to look at my wedgie jeans and everything. I think they also have the leather patch. So, and I don't know if they're premium or not. However, if you're curious as to what premium denim means, extra stitching per inch, as well as the patch in the back, the leather patch. Like I said, 100% cotton. And one of the biggest regrets I have is I had a pair of secondhand 501 jeans that I found, I don't know, in a thrift shop a long time ago. And they fit beautifully. They had washed down to the softest cotton feel, and they had molded to my body perfectly. And for the life of me, I cannot find them. That is like one of my biggest regrets. So you best believe these are not leaving my sight. Whenever we move or do anything, I'm gonna be doing an inventory of my 501s. So compare it to the A Goldie, 100% cotton, 100% cotton. Fits the same in terms of button fly. They're not high-waisted, neither of them. The fit is exactly the same. When I do the squat test, which you will see inserted in the frame, they fit comfortably. My butt is not hanging out. The interesting thing is the inseam on these is only 2 inches, whereas in the A Goldie it was 2.5 inches. Half an inch when it comes to shorts does make a difference. However, I am not self-conscious in these denim shorts. I absolutely love them. Here's the big thing, guys. Neither of them are made in the United States, even though they're 100% cotton, because sometimes, you know, made in the United States is an important thing to consider. For this, neither of them are made in the United States. I think A Goldie's in Turkey, and these Levi's are Cambodia, so not made in the United States. The price is the only thing that I can tell you is like the most glaring difference. these are $60. When I got them, and I got two pairs, here's a lighter, lighter wash denim. They almost look acid wash, but they're not, because I don't like acid wash, the look of acid wash. However, these are not acid wash. It's just, like I said, it's just a different wash. And this wash is called Waveline. This is called Indigo Avenue. When I got these, and the reason I have two of these is because they were 50% off. Levi's is always having sales. So I got, you know, a BOGO essentially, buy one, get one. You can't do that with a Goldie. I guess if I were comparing and there really was a beef, which one is better, I would say just the only difference is the price. And that can be prohibitive with some people. So if price is an issue, wait around for a sale for Levi's and you're gonna get them for 50% off. I doubt that you're gonna find these A Goldies ever on sale. So that's probably the only difference. Otherwise, both of these jeans are brilliant. I mean, they fit beautifully and they will mold to the body. They're really high quality. There's really not much that's different except for the price. So, I mean, I guess if there was this beef between Levi's and A Goldie, for me, it would come down to price. If I can't afford them, 9 times out of 10, I wait around and Levi's will come on sale. So there it is, you know, make of that what you will. But anyway, Levi's, love them, 100% cotton, will also mold to your body. One thing that's really important, guys, and I don't know if you saw this, this was a few years ago, the CEO of Levi's came out and said that he rarely ever washes his jeans. He says that it is not a good idea to wash denim because I believe it had to do with sustainability and the water that you use, that denim really does not need to be washed that much. In fact, I think he only spot treated it and he hung it outside if it started to smell or whatever. However, I'm not gonna go that far. I mean, I have worn jeans for a month or whatever and not washed them, and it wasn't a big deal. Am I gonna go through the life of my jeans and not wash them? No, but bottom line is, be careful. These do not need to be washed. Your denim shorts do not need to be washed with every, you know, after every single wearing. They just don't. If you do wash them, turn them inside out, wash them in cold water, and then hang dry. Do not put them in the dryer. Just a little tip to make your denim last longer. I don't know. I think it's gross. Just wash your jeans, dude. I don't know. I think they'll lie. Or you're the CEO. Get another pair. I don't know. But maybe his jeans look great. Who the hell knows? All right. So $60, I got these on sale, $128, no sale. I guess the winner in price is Levi's, okay? Next, American Eagle. Now, I got two American Eagle, surprise, surprise. You know, it's like I got two of everything. However, the reason I got two of these is because the two are like super loose. You'll see when I put in the insert, but they are so comfortable. They are baggy. They are kind of shapeless on me, but I don't care. These are the denim shorts that you put on when you're just lounging, when you're cleaning, when you're running to the grocery store, when you just want to wear a big, huge, baggy sweatshirt, you reach for these. Or when you're bloated and it's that time of the month, or you just don't want to mess with it and you don't feel like being constricted, the size two in the American Eagle. Now, you feel the cloth, and it is so much thinner than the Levi's, and it's so much thinner than the Goldie. But you know, these were $25. I mean, I think full price they're $49 or $50, and then I got them also for 50% off. I'm a bargain hunter, and so I got both of these for $50. I mean, you cannot beat that. And this is the 90s boyfriend, so the fit on these, they're a little bit high-waisted, not too much, because I just don't like that, in case you haven't gotten that by now. And they are mid-length, so they don't, I think, gosh, if I'm, I'll put in the inseam, I'll measure these and let you know what the inseam is. So that's what's, you know, kind of in trend right now. Even the Bermuda, I'm not a big Bermuda person, but these are perfect. These are the zeros. The butt looks better in the zeros in the 90s boyfriend, but the size twos are just, I mean, they're wonderful in terms of just lounging around. So this is the third price point. So we went from 128 to 60 to 50. And last but not least are the H&Ms. So the final price point, H&Ms, $17.99. Now, they fit, I mean, below 20 bucks, they fit amazingly. They are distressed again, just like all the others. Raw hem has, I believe, they've got a stretchiness to them, and that is because they are 99% cotton, 1% elastane. And so as you recall, if they're not 100% cotton, they can't be called denim. I'm still gonna call them denim, whatever. But they do have 1% elastane, and that gives them that stretchiness. I mean, even that one little percent, it fits beautifully. These are a little high-waisted on me, but they make the butt look good. And my God, for $17.99, and you know, at the end of the season, it's fast fashion, guys. H&M will have a sale, and I just got a pair of pants from there for $4.99. I didn't even know they were on sale for $10, and when I took them up, it was, so you know that's H&M for you. But make sure you recycle. Take your clothes and recycle, because they are good about that. However, I wanted to show you how nicely a pair of shorts under $20 look. They look beautiful, and you can style them. And you know, I don't know if it's a price is a factor or what, but I mean, I think even though they're $20, they're gonna last. So it's not like, you know, I at least won't throw these out. I think, you know, these are gonna be sitting in my closet just along with my Levi's, and I'm sure these also will get better with age. But I mean, the point is, you don't have to spend an arm and a leg. You don't have to go to the $128 price point in order to get a decent pair of denim shorts, as is evidenced by these H&M shorts. So that's the end of the video, guys. I wanted to show you that you don't need to spend an arm and a leg to have a decent pair of denim shorts. That's why I showed you the four different price points. You can spend an arm and a leg if you want to. You'll get amazing quality, but you don't have to. You can buy shorts for 20 bucks and they will still look fabulous. My next video, so make sure you ring the notification bell, is going to be all about styling denim shorts. And I will show you a handful, at least 10, 12 different ways that you can style your denim shorts that will take you through the rest of the summer. So please subscribe to my channel and have a great rest of your week. Bye.